So the first thing that I am doing is I am applying an eye primer. Now this eye primer is from the brand Freedom. Whatever products I am using will be in the description box, whatever I can find, don't worry about that. I'm spreading it with my fingers all across my eyes, ensuring that it spreads evenly, and then setting it with a powder. Now the reason why I'm setting it with a powder is because when I was applying the eyeshadows directly without setting it with the powder, it wasn't applying that great, and with the powder it was going really good. So that really worked for me. Now from the palette I'm using this burgundy shade right here, and I am directly applying it in my crease. Now if you are seeing this a little more properly, I am first just shaping and then I am darkening the color. Now this is a little different than my eye shape, to be really honest, as this trick, I don't know where did I see it, I remember seeing it somewhere, this just makes my eyes look bigger and better. So this really worked for me, and also I am concentrating it more towards the outside part and going really thin inside, and then I'm taking this burnt orange shade and I'm applying it all over my eyelid, like completely. I'm layering this up a little bit over and over, so this just really shows up. Maybe on camera if you can't see really that much of it, in person this looks really nice, and this looks really simple, so you can totally opt for this. Again, I am building up the orange so that it really shows on camera, because it wasn't showing that much, so I am doing that. And once I'm done with that, I am just blending the orange and the burgundy shade so that there are no harsh lines in between and it all looks nice and blended. I took a good time in the blending part because that's how the makeup really looks good, and blending is the key to beautiful makeup. And then I'm just finishing the look with an eyeliner. Now here I did not do the very prominent winged eyeliner, I just went for a normal eyeliner. I did not wing it out too much, just like slightly. And this trick that now I will be doing it, I have been doing it for quite a while, that's why I'm really comfortable with keeping my eyes open and doing the inner 1/4 of my eyes. Please don't try it at home, it might hurt. And this is how the finished look looks like. I'm sorry if my hair doesn't look good. I really forgot to plan the hairstyles with these eye makeup looks. Jumping on to the next one. Honestly, this is my favorite look out of the three looks that I've created. I'm doing the same step again. I'm applying the eye primer first, spreading it all over my eyes evenly so that the eyeshadow goes really well. And then I am setting it with a powder. Again, now I'm going with this dark brown shade. And here I did not really plan to go for a specific shape. I'm just applying it on my outer 1/4 and then just going in my crease. I'm not going over, I'm just going like in that hollow part of it and then just dragging it down. And then using this shimmery brown shade with my fingers, I'm just applying it in my inner 1/4, and then I dragged it a little bit more inside towards my half, and then I just sort of did a permutation combination and saw what works for my eyes. So outer 1/4 and inner 3/4 really worked for me, so I went for that. And then I'm just applying a brown kajal that I have from Nikake. This really worked for me, so I'm applying it in my waterline, and then even in the upper lash line I'm just going like just 1/4 in the outer part. This just helps my eyes look bigger. This is a trick that really works for me, so I did that. And then because I wasn't really happy with the brown, I took this light brown shade and then just went above and just blended the brown, because this was really looking nice, and overall the eye look was really getting affected a lot. And then I really went heavy with the mascara because it was opening my eyes very well, so as a result I really liked how it looked. And this is the finished eye makeup look. Honestly, this reminds me of some character from some movie, but I don't remember which one exactly. If you can remember something, please let me know in the comments. But I really loved this. Also, hello new hair, I just cut them 2-3 days back and I'm completely obsessed with my hair all over again. Jumping to the third eye makeup look, again I am doing the same process, applying the eye primer first using my fingers, evenly spreading it all across, and then I am going to be setting it with my powder. Now the reason why I tell you to apply it evenly is because if you apply the eye primer a little bit extra in one particular space, it's not going to work that great for you. You will understand when you practically do it. Now I'm going to take this pastel purple shade and go in my crease. Again, this color was actually taking a while to show up. Maybe it's because of my dusky skin, maybe because of that. But yeah, I took a little bit of extra product and then it was really showing up, so I was happy with it. Now I'm taking this burgundy shade right here. I am not even joking, this took so much time for me. By the end of this look, my eyes were actually paining and I could see everything double. Honestly, my eyes were really paining because the color was just not showing up. In real time, it took me like half an hour. Okay, so this was a real pain. Now I'm taking the shimmery shade and I'm just applying it in my inner one third area and then just blending the burgundy with the shimmery shade, and then I'm just trying to go with the pastel purple shade so everything looks blended, it looks clean and nothing looks shabby or unblended or anything with harsh edges. So once I was happy with it, I just applied my eyeliner, and honestly it was so difficult for me to apply the liner, but I managed it through. And yep, again I did not go for a very solid thick eyeliner, I just went for a thinner one, and this is the finished eye makeup look. I really hope you guys liked it. Please don't mind my hairstyle and I'll see you next time. Bye.